Yes Have Some Podcast is excited to tell our listeners about Dr. Pepper and the brand new collectible cans from Spider-Man Far From Home. Collectors, it's time to make that decision. Are you going to drink these Dr. Peppers or are you going to leave them mint in package? Either way, you got to collect all five cans available now, including the new limited time flavor Dr. Pepper Dark Berry featuring Mysterio. Get your hands on all five of the new Spider-Man Far From Home cans from Dr. Pepper available at Walmart.
Jurassic Park. Now playing the theater.
Ecto Gunnels with Ecto Bomber, Neutrona Blaster, and Water Zapper each sold separately.
From the corner penthouse of Spook Central all the way to Star Killer Base, this is Yes Have Some Podcast.
Do I?
Yes Have Some.
Yes Have Some.
You know, they told me you people were conceited douchebags.
The only place in the multiverse where you can love the book, hate the movie, but still buy all the toys.
I'm afraid you're just too darn loud.
I'm not looking for a friend. I'm looking for a Jedi Master.
A what?
Please remember to hold on to your butts and get ready to get stressed with your hosts, Craig Goldberg, Abigail Gardner, and Jacob Walsh.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Yes Have Some Podcast. This is a very special edition of Yes Have Some. This is not our regular episode for this week. This is a little bonus where we have, once again, joining us, Lani Sarem from Wizard World, who is giving us updates on Ghostbusters FanFest. We are only 2 weeks away from FanFest. There is more information. Had a good chat, Jake and I. Abigail was MIA, but Jake and myself talked to Lani, and we got some good information for everybody, including some new stuff, some updates. We're all very excited for FanFest. So, without further ado, here is Lani Sarem. Lani Sarem, who is the organizer, the planner, the producer, many titles for Ghostbusters FanFest, which we are only a couple weeks from. So, Lani, welcome back to Yes Have Some Podcast.
Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. So, basically, we reached out last week and said, do you want to come back on and give some updates, talk about, you know, any changes, important information that people will need as we gear up for the event. So, I guess we talked to you about a month ago. So, what has the last month been like? Has it been insane?
Oh yeah! Oh my gosh, was that a month ago? That's crazy.
Yeah.
It seemed like it was like literally a week ago.
Yeah, I don't think I've slept much since then. And Wizard World, actually, we have, after Ghostbusters, we have our big show in Philly the very next week. So I'm looking forward to getting some sleep around June 17th, 18th. So
okay. Don't sleep at FanFest. Like, don't find a bench on the Sony lot and take a nap. That won't be good.
No, I don't plan on it. Though, if you see me leaned up against the pole and I've fallen asleep, just, you know, shake me for, you know, please. So
that's funny.
So much has happened. You know, we've been, you know, scrambling to lock down all the details and, you know, get everything ready. We're really excited about everything that's going to be happening. We talked about having the screening, which, of course, I'm excited to announce it's going to be at the beautiful and supposedly haunted. So, you know, maybe you'll see a real ghost at the Globe Theater on Friday night. The Globe Theater is actually the oldest still working theater in downtown LA. It opened in 1913. So if there are any ghosts that show up, I'm sure they're really cool ghosts from, you know, way back in the day. So
cool.
Yeah. So we're really excited about that. It's beautiful inside. And I think the screening there will be really special. So that's going to be happening on Friday night, and then, you know, Saturday, as you know, on the Sony lot, we can officially announce the hours now. So 12 to 8 are the hours of the event on the Sony lot, unless you're a class 10, and then you have breakfast, and you'll be getting information on where that is actually happening very soon.
Very cool.
And we're also pulling together an official after party, or unofficial after party. That is unofficially happening.
Okay.
Right. Because of all the amazing fan groups that are coming into town. So, that's going to be, you know, probably happening right after the event somewhere close by. So we'll be releasing all that information soon. And, you know, there's, you know, probably going to be some other announcements that are come out to press very soon. Did you, the last time you guys had me on the show, I was saying that we were going to have a new announcement soon, but I couldn't tell you who it was. And we finally made that announcement. Was that any of the people that you were thinking of, or?
So, yeah, so that was Paul Feig, correct? And, my theory was that it was somebody related to Answer the Call, just doing my own little detective work. But no, I think that's great. And we've actually had Paul, on the show before he was like editing the movie. They were a couple months from release, and we used to do these live call-in shows, and he just called in and talked for 45 minutes. And like, it's just a testament to how amazing of a guy Paul is that, you know, I know he cares a lot about the fans and the franchise, and he's been through the ringer himself with some of the not so savory parts of the fandom. So I think it's amazing that he's going to be there. And the director's panel sounds like a really cool thing.
Yeah, I think that's kind of a once, probably never going to happen again thing.
Yeah.
The director's panel with Paul and Jason and Ivan, that actually took a lot of work to pull together. And Paul's actually filming over in London right now. So it was even a challenge to kind of work it out in his schedule. So I was really excited when it was pulled together, and I think, you know, for any diehard fans of the franchise, that'll be a really interesting, unique thing that, like I said, I don't think will ever happen again. So I was, you know, really excited that we were able to make that one happen.
Yeah, no, it's amazing. I mean, I think there's not too many people who have directed a Ghostbusters movie, so actually
there's two so far. Yeah, and two, there's about to be a third,
right? So
and two of them are related. So.
Right.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting. I feel like there's a lot to discuss as far as like anytime you can just get a director's viewpoint and kind of get into their mind a little bit in kind of one of these panel situations where fans have a chance to like ask questions. That's amazing. So should be a really unique aspect for FanFest.
Right. I think a couple other things that, you know, just wanting to highlight some of the other exciting elements of the day is, you know, Ray Parker Jr.'s documentary will be premiering at the festival, along with Cleaning Up the Town documentary is also premiering at the festival. So those have never been seen before and will be seen for the first time. And then, you know, I think you guys know that there's some never-before-seen footage on the new Blu-ray, and you'll actually, if you come to the screening on Friday night, you get to see some of those clips first before they out on
That's
that
amazing.
Blu-ray on Tuesday. So you get to see them before anyone else. And I've heard a rumor that there might be some other things that, you know, never before seen things that could end up somewhere at the festival, but
oh boy.
I make no promises, but you never know.
Right.
Never know.
I love a good rumor. I feel like, so we've talked to a lot of people. We've got, you know, tons of friends. There's literally people coming in from all over the world. And like, the one thing I keep telling everybody is like, you know, prepare to have an experience that you've never had before, probably will never have again. It's not just a gathering of Ghostbusters fans. There's going to be a lot of exclusive content. We've got a new movie coming out a year from now. Who knows what kind of surprises could be in store? And just a chance to be around the creators of the franchise is amazing. So I think everybody's everybody's frothing at the mouth for as much detail as possible. But I just keep stressing, just be patient. It's coming.
Well, you know, sometimes having all the information is fun, but, you know, sometimes being surprised, pleasantly surprised is always fun too. So, you know, the world has become this place where, you know, it's so easy to get information and, you know, you don't know something, you can Google it in 5 seconds and you can, you know, someone can email you or send you a picture or send you a video right away. And, you know, we're so used to having all this information right there that we, you know, start to get anxious if we don't have information sometimes. But, you know, sometimes the fun little surprises along the way can be enjoyable. People used to, I think, do a better job of enjoying life and living in the moment. And now we need all this information. And information is good. I'm not saying it's not. But, you know, just come and live in the moment. You know?
I agree. Live in the moment and also, like, be like, I think sometimes people just get predisposed to be like, I can't wait to be mad about this one thing. And it's just like, like, if it's in your head that you're already going to be bummed about it, like, the odds of you being bummed are that much more. So,
it's true. Expectation is a funny thing. Like, when I'm usually so much more pleasantly surprised when I put expectations on something. When I put expectations on something, I get a lot more disappointed. I think that happened with, like, the Game of Thrones season this year. Like, the show's been so good that people just, they put their expectations put on the last season to be this everything you could ever want. Everybody would be happy. You know, it just doesn't always work. So, you know, I there were some things about it that I didn't love either. But at the same time, like, I feel like I don't know that anything would have made, you know, people happy because the expectation was just so high. So, I think.
We literally
go ahead.
I was just gonna say, we literally had like a 45 minute therapy session in our last episode about Game of Thrones.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, no, but it's true, because like before this last season, like, so many people were just like, it's gonna be amazing and every episode's gonna be like a movie, and I just remember being like, man, I've watched plenty of TV in my lifetime, and I know it's really hard to end a show. So just like brace yourself for impact, I guess.
Yeah, it's almost, the better the show, the harder the last season is, because and you know, I've had so many shows that I've loved, and I have very few where I was like happy with. I liked for the most part, I liked the last episode of Friends. But there aren't many others. I mean, I would love Dexter. I was so upset over the whole last season of that, the last episode. You know, there's so many shows. The last, Big Love, that was another one I loved. Last couple episodes. Yeah,
it's hard.
Really tough. I think the better the show, the harder it is to end them and make the fans happy. So.
Definitely, definitely. By the way, the end of Friends was great.
We're going to try to make everybody happy at FanFest.
Yes.
So that's the goal.
I love it. It's like we do the FanFest interview. We end up breaking down the validity of Ross and Rachel's relationship at the end of Friends. So
they were meant to be.
They were. By the way, I will defend the end of Lost for the rest of my life because I loved it, but that's a whole other story. So a couple things. So I was glad that you talked about the schedule. So so it's going to be 12 to 8. The Class 10 breakfast will maybe start a little bit earlier. Those details are going to be coming out. As far as...
the Class 10 breakfast will definitely start earlier than that.
Cool, very cool. And I know everybody's really excited about that. One question that we do get a lot, is specifically with like the packages, is the Class 10 guests that are included with the package. I know there's been a lot of guests that have been added, which is great. But those guests are not included with the Class 10 package for photos and autographs. But the website has stated that more to be announced. So I guess you can, if you want to speak to maybe not specifics if they're not available, but will there be the potential for more guests added to those higher tier packages?
There is the potential. I mean, the one photo op that has come out for available to Class 10 since the original is the Jason Ivan photo op together that will be included in all the Class 10 packages, and that's a new item, and that may, you guys may not have gotten that info yet via your packages, so I may be announcing that here, but something that's going to come.
That's amazing. Yeah, I think that's breaking news. I did see that package
there
was.
There you go. I just broke it.
I like it. No, I like it. I think people.
It's a good one.
That's a great one. I mean, again, when else would you have that opportunity unless you were like part of the Reitman family?
right.
So that's amazing. And then, oh gosh, there was one thing. It just escaped me. Maybe it'll come back to me. Oh, here it is. So as far as scheduling goes for the day, I know you guys are going to be putting out like a full schedule at some point soon. Is it reasonable to expect, like most conventions, like overlapping, content? Basically, like, you know, we'll have to kind of plan and pick and choose what we want to do throughout the day. Or is it kind of like there's going to be like one main panel going on at a time, and it's just, maybe you could speak to that a little bit.
Yeah, so there's going to be, like, throughout the day, there's going to be different things going on at different times. You know, for instance, you know, they're like, the documentaries are going to be playing at the same time as the panels are going. So you may have to choose, you know, whether you're going to go see one of the documentaries or you're going to go see a panel about, you know, and I'm not saying these two are looking to each other, so, because I'm not looking at the schedule right now, but for instance, you know, there's some gaming panels, and, like, there's one that's going to involve, like, the 2009 video game panel, so, like, that one might be up against, say, one of the documentaries. Again, I'm not saying that's what's happening, but, so you may have to choose in regard to that, but, there's the main panels are that, so towards the second half of the day when we all come together for the director panel, there's a main cast panel, Ghostbusters and the Ray Parker Jr. performance, and some stuff from Jason, whatever that stuff might be. Those are going to be happening on the main stage, and there won't be other things conflicting at that point.
Okay.
So,
cool.
So
cool.
All the main stuff, no, and not that it's not all, it's all main, you know what I'm saying, but
right,
but some of the other panels, you know, that there will be different panels running at the same time earlier in the day, as you know, because, you know, not everybody is going to necessarily want to go watch a documentary that day, or, you know, some people may care less about the video game and that kind of stuff, but we know everybody's going to want to see all the main.
Right, like the main program. And you say the main...
I think that's something some people were worried about.
Yeah, yeah. Like,
well, tell them no fear.
No fear.
We got it.
I mean,
we got you.
I might actually wear a no fear shirt just to throw it back. So you mentioned the main stage.
I used to have a sticker on my car that said, "Drive it like you stole it, no fear."
Oh, good,
and then my
good
car got stolen.
Oh no.
My God.
That was serendipitous.
right.
So the main stage, we've seen the map. The talented John Yerkeba, who's the unofficial fourth member of Yes Have Some Podcast. He worked
and
on.
And he's gonna be at FanFest as well, along with some other great artists.
Yes.
Like Tim Latin.
Ooh, very cool, very cool. Yeah, we're excited. He's very excited. His output is insane. The guy. There'll be times like. There's been times where we've recorded an episode. Now, this happens all the time. We'll have some inside joke, and like 40 minutes after the episode's finished, he's sending us artwork based on our inside joke. So, John's the best. But getting back to the main stage where some of the main programming is going to be, that stage is outdoors, correct?
Okay. So I had this really clever answer, and it sounds less clever after you say it three times.
No, it's fine. It's fine.
So I said, it is outdoors. And I said, for those of you that don't live in California, you may worry about what happens if it rains in California. And my answer is, you know, please listen to the Mamas and the Papas song. It never rains.
It never rains in California. Actually, we've been scouting out the weather. It actually looks like, it's also going to be maybe like in the mid 70s, which is amazing.
That's typical for LA. There is a good chance it may be like overcast. They call it June gloom. So it may not be, you know, whether the sun is brightly shining down and you need sunscreen, or whether it's overcast, if you're supposed to wear sunscreen, I've heard, is kind of a little bit more up in the air. But I think either way, like, you don't need to bring your parkas. That's probably a good bet. Though I will say, if you've never been to California, especially Los Angeles, after the sun goes down, it does
get chilly. So bring, you know, do bring a light snack. I think you'll be okay.
Good. Good call. Good advice. Good advice. Good important safety tip. Also, main stage panel, I'm assuming there will be seating, and I know that there's priority seating for the upperclassmen, for the seniors and juniors. I know that's really cool. I think it's really cool that there's going to be that main stage. Then I'm assuming some of the other programming will be kind of spread out through. Well, look at the map, everybody. There's a map.
Well, yeah. So Sony has these really cool theaters that are actually used to, you know, when a filmmaker is you know, in the process of making a movie, or, you know, you want to gather some of the cast and crew together, or friends or whoever, that hold a few hundred people. They're different sizes. But so a lot of the panels will be taking place in those theaters. So that will actually be indoors. And then, you know, like photo ops will be indoors, but the rest of it will kind of be outdoors and, you know, in different parts of the lot. This is probably one of the few chances that somebody who doesn't work on the lot gets to kind of roam around. You're basically, you know, the lot doesn't allow visitors unless you're taking a studio tour. And on a studio tour, you're very much treated like a child. Like, okay, we're all going to stay together. And this is kind of your shot to kind of get to wander around the lot as if worked there, but in a Ghostbuster uniform.
I remember sneaking into Ghost Corps when I did the studio tour. It was very fun. Everybody was in the I asked permission from Eric ahead of time, and then he wasn't there, so I looked like I was just not knowing what I was doing. I was extremely stressed out about it, but I did it nonetheless.
Well, I won't tell Sony that you snuck into Ghost Corps while you're on the sunny lot. So they don't come in, you know, arrest you or anything.
That's funny. They, like, we walk into FanFest, Jake gets escorted out immediately.
What the best part about it was, the woman who was working, like, the front desk in there was like, what are you doing? And I tried to explain to her that I asked, you know, ahead of time if it was okay. And she was like, what did Eric tell you come in here? Like, almost like she was annoyed with Eric. I was like, oh boy,
that's funny.
I think Eric's kind of the boss around there, so she'd have been annoyed, but you know, yeah. I think you're okay. When I walk in there, and I've been in there so many times now, usually, like, they'll be like, can we, and I'm like, I'm gonna see Eric, and then, you know, they kind of look at him like, Do you know this girl? Like,
that's so funny.
Maybe it happens often. Maybe people just go in there often.
Yeah, that's really funny.
Maybe.
So cool. So lots happening. I know that, like, managing. So I do project management during the day for my job that's not podcasting, and I know how hard it is. So on behalf of everybody, we appreciate all the hard work that you guys are putting into it, and the tireless hours of planning and rearranging. Like, the thing I think that I wish I could tell everybody is, like, the nature of these kinds of things is that everything is always in flux and changing up until, like, the day of. It's just the way it is. It's really hard to lock in the final plan because there's so many moving parts.
It's a lot of moving parts. It's a lot of people, you know, and a lot of schedules. And a lot of, you know, just kind of coordinating and figure things out. And then, you know, something changes, and that there's a domino effect that changes 9,000 other things. You know, Wizard World as a company, we sometimes put on up to 26 conventions across the country in a year. And, you know, there's a lot to those that are kind of similar in the sense of, like, you know, we go into a convention center and, you know, we put up the same sign. You know, and you know, obviously the shows are great, and we have different talent at the shows, and, you know, there's lots of things about them that are different. But, you know, like, kind of our process, this process was completely different. You know, we don't usually work outside. We don't usually work on a studio lot. You know, our shows are, you know, pop culture conventions with all kinds of people. You know, this one was very specific. So there was a lot of extra parts to this one that, you know, we that don't normally happen. So I can tell you that the Wizard World team has spent a lot of tireless hours, you know, making and, you know, painstakingly going through this and wanting to make this the very best event possible. And you know, we really hope that everybody has a great time because it's been a labor of love for a while. So,
that's amazing. I love it.
We're really excited to put it on, but you know, it's definitely been a new experience in a lot of ways. So,
and what are the odds of getting a panel of Dan Aykroyd just pitching new concepts for Ghostbusters movies for like 3 hours straight? Because I could listen to that man talk about his ideas for Ghostbusters for like, I don't know, the rest of my life.
That's probably going to be every panel he's on.
I'll definitely bring it up. I don't know that we have a three-hour panel where Dan does that, but
that's so fun.
You know, I'll definitely mention that was asked for. Dan's going to be a pretty busy guy on Saturday, to be honest. I can imagine. He's got the busiest schedule. I actually had a conversation today about we probably are going to have to put somebody with him to kind of like help get him from place to place because he's going to be, you know, quite on demand, but, you know, there's going to be so many other cool people and things going on and, you know, I think if the combination is, as Garrick said in the video that Ghost Corpse put out that was super cool, you know, you probably will never be able to find this collection of things and people from the original movie unless you went back to the original movie itself, which would be kind of hard to do unless you can get the DeLorean.
Ooh,
back to the future.
Confirmed. So, DeLorean, you know, then, at Ghost Core. Yeah, right. No. Yeah, it's amazing, and I don't think that's lost on anybody. I mean, it's in the nature of people who go to conventions to be very stressed out because we're all like full of, you know, just general anxiety and social anxiety, all the anxiety that you can have. We all have it. So I've just been telling everybody, just roll with it. It's going to be amazing. And there's so many good guests. Like we're kind of doing mini interviews with a couple different people leading up to FanFest. So we talked to Jennifer Runyon the other night. And she was great. We'll have Robin Shelby on next week and a couple other people that we're working on. So and everybody's just super excited.
I feel like the photo op with Steve and Jennifer would be like such a cool photo op. You could almost be like, you know, Bill Murray in that scene where you're like trying to ask them questions and, you know,
yeah.
That one. I was really excited because we got Jennifer Runyon to sign on first, and then I was having trouble in the beginning kind of getting a commitment from Steve. And I was like, no, we gotta have him. And I was really excited when he finally signed on because, you know, I was like, oh, it's gonna be a bummer if we get Jennifer and not Steve, and we got both of them. And then I was like, yes, I felt like that was a successful like accomplishment by me. So
no, that's great. He's
nice.
He's amazing. He's they're both. That'll be a lot of fun. That will be a good photo op. And yeah, it's all good. I mean, it's essentially everybody that you could, well, almost everybody that you could hope for. You know, and it's awesome. We've had Violet Ramis on the podcast. It's awesome that she'll be there, and her book's incredible. And I'm sure she'll be talking about that, and it'll be a cool chance for people to meet her as she carries on her dad's legacy in the Ghostbusters world.
Right. Definitely, yeah. Definitely. I mean, of course, we would have all loved for Harold to be there himself.
Before we finish up our conversation with Lainey, we did want to let everybody know that Yes Have Some podcast will be out at Ghostbusters Fan Fest, and we want everybody to come say hi. We want to say hi to you. We want to meet you. We want to know you. We want to move into your homes. No, but seriously, we're going to be handing out some merch, some YHS swag, some new buttons just came in today. You can see it on the Instagram at YHS Podcast. So we just want you guys to know that we are going to be hanging out all week in LA, we're going to be at the screening, and we're going to big dinners. We want to have everybody out for some big dinners. We would love to meet our listeners. So if you're going out to Ghostbusters Fan Fest, make sure if you see us, you run up to us and you say hi. You don't have to run. Actually, don't run. Security's going to be tight at Fan Fest. There's a lot going on. But seriously, we want to meet everybody. So that's my little PSA. Back to the interview. Okay, so to wrap it up, we got schedule's coming. Oh, one last question. As far as vendors, we've heard a lot about like different, you know, companies who put out Ghostbusters merchandise being there on site. Are you able to talk about anybody who's going to be there as of yet?
I don't know if I'm supposed to officially announce any of the vendors or licensees, but there's several of them coming. I guess, what are you trying to ask me? And I'll tell you if I can answer it or not.
Well, there's companies that are kind of, you know, different toy companies, Funko, Diamond Select, who put out really great Ghostbusters merchandise. I think people are just kind of wondering, will those kinds of even if we don't go into specific, will those types of companies be on site with new product?
We specifically, went out to a lot of the main licensees, and a lot of them are coming, and I think you'll be excited to see a lot of those, and a couple that are going to be in it that you might not know, you might not think of, but that have some cool stuff coming out that I think you'll be excited about. So.
Very cool. Yeah, I think we're all toy collectors, so we're all kind of like on pins and needles waiting to see what toy company is going to be doing the toys for the new movie and all that kind of stuff. And I know Eric mentioned there will be a toy panel as well, so that's very cool.
There is a toy panel. And that has nothing to do with Toy Story 4, but that is why Annie Potts won't be able to make it because she has Toy Story 4 press.
And we understand. We're not happy about it, but we understand. And Jake, they were gonna ask you to moderate the toy panel, but they found out about you sneaking into Ghost Core and they canceled it.
So. It's fine. I'll sneak into that too.
I'll sneak into the panel. Blake, Jake, you've got a Class 10 badge on. You didn't have to sneak in.
You're right.
Yeah. Well, cool. So, Lani, thank you so much for joining us for a little bit here. I think everybody listening to this, everybody knows where to get all the information, but we'll keep pushing it and promoting it. We can't wait to see everybody. Anything else but before we let you go, any other little nuggets of information or teases or anything that you want to say?
Not off the top of my head, I can't think of anything, but if I do, maybe I'll shoot you a quick text or an email and let you know if, but just, be on the lookout next week for, I think a lot of, you guys are going to start to see a lot of info come out and, things are going to come to you, especially those in the class 10s. You'll get some more information about certain things. And we're really excited to see you guys all so soon. The screening's 2 weeks from today.
2 weeks from today?
That's crazy.
And then 2 weeks from tomorrow is the unofficial, official, unofficial after party, which I'm very excited about. And
exactly. And maybe the official 35th anniversary of the movie.
Oh, yeah. Let's not forget why we're all celebrating. I'm like, is Jason Reitman going to be there? Who else is going to be there? What toys are we going to be there? Like, oh, yeah, it's the 35th anniversary of Ghostbusters. Cool. Well, Lani, we will talk to you soon.
It makes us all feel very old, but that's, I guess that's how life is.
It's also the 35th anniversary of me. So I'm one in the same with Ghostbusters.
Happy 35th. When is your birthday? Is your birthday before or after?
Before March. So I had a 4 month head start or a 3 month head start on Ghostbusters.
So do you remember watching it in the theater when it first came out?
No. I do remember seeing Ghostbusters 2 in theaters. I was already obsessed at that point. So.
Wow, yeah. That's
it was very. Tell again another thing I wish my parents were impressed with. They're not. So it's well, Lani, thank you so much. We will see you soon, and for everybody else, stay tuned to Wizard World for those updates, and we'll all be out in LA together in 2 weeks.
See you then. All right, thanks guys.
Lani. Thank you. Bye.
All right.